10 little signs that you are really a genius. You may be a real genius, but you just don't know it. Although the genius traits manifest themselves in tiny signs, there are some symptoms that indicate that you are an intelligent person. Here are some proven facts to find out if you are a genius. Let's take a look at the first one. You are the oldest child in the family. If you are the oldest of your brothers and sisters, you will certainly have more intelligence than they do. Numerous studies claim that older children are more likely to be geniuses than younger siblings. The New York Times reported on a landmark study. Its results, published in June 2007, showed that the oldest children, on average, had an IQ difference of 3 points compared to their next younger siblings. According to the results, the difference is not due to biological factors, but to a psychological interaction between parents and children. Because of this, it is clear that the oldest children are more intelligent than the younger ones. So, if you're the oldest in the family, congratulations! You're a genius! You were in a music class. This may sound a little vague, but it has been confirmed by many researchers. If you learned music in your childhood, there is a chance that you will have a higher IQ than those who did not have music lessons in their early years. The results of a 2011 study showed that children between the ages of 4 and 6 achieved better results in oral intelligence tests a few months after starting music lessons. Schellenberg repeated an earlier study in 2013 and concluded that 6-year-olds who attended music lessons for 9 months had the highest IQ growth, unlike their peers who did not attend separate music courses. So, if you have had musical education, it will have affected your intelligence and cognitive abilities such as perception, attention, memory, imagination, and thinking. You are slim. A slim figure shows a strong correlation with the IQ value. If you're not obese, you're probably a genius. Researchers conducted intelligence tests on 2,200 adults for 5 years, and those whose waist width increased achieved poorer cognitive performance. A 2006 study found that 40-year-olds who did worse in their oral and written exams at the age of 11 were likely to be overweight. The researchers said that smarter children found better learning opportunities than their less intelligent comrades, and thus achieved higher social and salary status. This created more ideal conditions for them to take care of their health. However, recent results in children of kindergarten age have shown that a lower IQ is associated with a higher BMI. Since body mass index and smartness are related to socioeconomic status, scientists today say that environmental factors also need to be studied. You worry more than anyone. It is also a sign of genius and high IQ when you think and worry a lot about life. According to numerous studies on anxiety, there is growing evidence that anxious people are more intelligent than others in some respects. In a study, 126 school leavers were asked how often they were worried. Psychologist Edward Shelby shared the details of his findings in Psychology Today. According to his study, students were also asked how often they thought about circumstances that made them feel uneasy. In the end, it turned out that the students who were anxious and thoughtful scored better on verbal intelligence tests than those who did not worry or ponder so much. You are funny. Yes, if you have a good sense of humor, you're probably a genius. Numerous studies have shown that people who have a sense of humor and are funnier or more creative than others also achieve better results in intelligence tests. 400 psychology students completed an intelligence test in which abstract and verbal intelligence were measured. They were then asked to produce subtitles for some New York cartoons, which were then checked by independent reviewers. It turned out that more intelligent students were perceived as more amusing. So, you're a genius if you're a real joker. You are always curious. There's no genius who isn't curious. A genius always asks for the meaning of things and is constantly driven by curiosity. Such people are generally more creative and always interested in what is going on in the world. They approach problems intelligently that less intelligent people would not be able to solve. They are indeed the ones who really contribute a lot to the development and improvement of the world. According to Albert Einstein, the important thing is not to stop questioning. Curiosity has its own reason for existence. The Goldsmiths Research Group at the University of London found that the intellectual investment of the individual, i.e., all the things in which he intellectually invests time and energy, plays an important role in his cognitive development. You are a little messy. This may be good news for you, but your mother probably won't be so happy. You may think it's just a bad habit to have a mess in your room or workplace, but some research suggests that those who have a messy environment are certainly more creative and intelligent. Kathleen Vose of the University of Minnesota says, "Working in a chaotic environment effectively promotes creativity." 48 people took part in an experiment to invent alternative uses for a table tennis ball. Half of the participants working in a beautifully furnished room had fewer ideas than the other team working in a crowded room. If you're a clutterer and someone asks you to clean up your room, just tell them you're living out your creativity. You are left-handed. Scientists have repeatedly pointed out that left-handers are generally more imaginative, think differently, and argue better than right-handers. Left-handedness has long been associated with criminal predisposition, and it is still questionable why there are more left-handers among criminals. A current study links left-handedness with an unusual, different way of thinking that enables inspiring creativity, at least in men. In the men's group, it was found that left-handers did better in tests for unusual thinking. The left-handed could more cleverly combine two existing objects into a third. For example, a pole and a tin can into a birdhouse. They were also excellent at putting words from different lists into as many groups as possible. You're a night owl. I'm sure you'll love this sign. The early bird catches the worm, it is said, but some studies suggest exactly the opposite. Those who stay up late are often more diligent, unless they are just watching a movie or just hanging around on the internet looking for a partner. One study found that night owls are intellectually superior to early risers when all factors are considered. Ethnographic research showed that primitive humans were less active at night, but they talked a lot to each other. Therefore, those who remain awake are wiser and more receptive to learning new, value-adding activities. Everything seems so simple to you. I'm not saying that laziness equals intelligence, but the wise don't have to make as much effort as the fighters to develop their abilities, at least in some areas. The psychologists David Z. Hambrick and Elizabeth J. Mines published a study in the New York Times that they conducted among particularly bright young people at Vanderbilt University. As part of their research, they tracked 2,000 people who were among the top 1% in the SAT, Scholastic Assessment Test. Hambrick and Mines compared those who reached only 99.1% in intellectual ability at the age of 12 and those who reached 99.9%. It turned out that students who reached 99.9% were 3 to 5 times more likely to do a doctorate, defend a patent, publish in scientific journals, or publish a literary work. They came to the conclusion that while the pursuit of more knowledge is admirable, certain inner abilities cannot always be learned. Well, how many signs do you see in yourself? Are you a genius? Would you like to improve yourself even more? Make the most of yourself. Download our 10 scientifically proven methods by which you can speed up your learning. If you like the video, subscribe to our channel and learn something new and useful week by week. Go for it!